Good morning, everybody. Welcome to our time of praise and worship this morning. As everybody get a join and take a seat in their pew. Good morning, Doug. Why, there's a new function on Facebook. I can wave to you now, apparently. Good morning, Kevin. Good morning, all. Good morning, Daniel. They must have updated over the weekend the Facebook application, because it's given me the option here to bring you onto the camera, Doug. I won't do it for share of your blushes, but something to look at for the future. Clearly, Facebook is assisting us in coming together. Good morning, Jill. Good morning, Jean. Good morning, Steve. Good morning, Alan. Good morning, Karen. Good morning, Sue. It's all good to have you here this morning. Good morning, Gavin. Some of you may or may not have seen, I put a post up. Good morning, Ashley. A post up on the site to say if you have any prayer requests, just pop it in the comments. It doesn't have to be War and Peace. Just put the name, your first name, second name, but something general. Could be that they're sick, or just general prayer, or we want to include them, and I'll make sure when I do the intercessions that we cover them off there. So the power of prayer is something not to be messed with. It is great and strong and joyous. I can see that, because after 35 days of testing positive to COVID-19, my mother with two pre-existing conditions has finally tested negative. So has moved from the COVID ward back into the arms of the stroke ward, so they can look after her there. So 35 days with no symptoms. It's a blessing, but it's a very challenging time that we live, and something we shouldn't take into granted, considering some people who are fit and healthy, you know, have been taken from their loved ones. So let us be thankful and not dismiss that amazing thing that is prayer. So I think without ado, I shall begin. We have the obligatory starting at five, about 5 minutes late, just so we can feel like we are in church and running as normal. This is where David's now saying, we never start late. Good morning, all. You should have received your order of service via email from David. So you can join in the bits in bold. If you didn't, I'm sure you will know the responses. And if you didn't, and you say, you can say any old response, because the Lord knows what's in your heart, and that's what matters to him. Let us take a moment. O Lord, open our lips, and our mouths shall proclaim your praise. In your resurrection, O Christ, let heaven and earth rejoice. Alleluia. We have come together in the name of Christ to offer our praise and thanksgiving, to hear and receive God's holy word, to pray for the need of the world, and to seek the forgiveness of our sins, that we may by the power of the Holy Spirit, that we may give ourselves to the service of God. Jesus says, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is close at hand. So let us turn away from our sin and turn to Christ. Let us take a moment to confess our sins in our hearts, in penitence and faith. And we say together, Lord God, we have sinned against you, and we have done evil in your sight. We are sorry and repent. Have mercy on us according to your love. Wash away our wrongdoing and cleanse us from our sins. Renew our right spirit within us and restore us to the joy of your salvation through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And may the Father of all mercies cleanse us from our sins and restore us in his image to the praise and glory of his name through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Blessed is the Lord, for he has heard the voice of our prayers. Therefore shall our hearts dance for joy, and in our song we shall praise our God. And our prayer for thanksgiving is, Blessed are you, Lord God of our salvation, to whom are you praise and glory forever. As once you ransomed your people from Egypt and led them to freedom in the promised land, so now you are deliver us from the domination of darkness and brought us into the kingdom of the risen Son. May we, the first fruits of your new creation, rejoice in this new day for you have made and praise you your mighty acts. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Blessed be God forever. The night has passed and the day lies open before us. Let us pray with one heart and mind. As we rejoice in the gifts of this new day, so may the light of your presence, O God, set our hearts on fire with love for you, now and forever. Amen. Now we go to a hymn, and this hymn takes me back to my childhood. It's probably the earliest memory I can probably come to, standing in the school hall in Elton Primary School, singing this song. I used to sing it with gusto then. I'm going to save you the rendition of my voice this morning. And I will warn you, there isn't much of an introduction, so it's just straight in there. And as we said earlier on about dancing with joy, so now we have our hymn, Lord of the Dance.
Thank you.
I totally agree with you, Daniel. It's been a while since I've heard that one, and I'm sure it brings back some memories, maybe good or bad, but it's a joyous song, and you can't help toe-tapping and joining in some ways. But I did save you from me at full voice, just to save the family blushes. We now go on to our psalm for today, which is Psalm number 145, verses 8 to 15. The Lord is gracious and merciful, long-suffering and great goodness. The Lord is loving to everyone, and his mercy is over all his creatures. All your work praise you, O Lord, and your faithful servants bless you. They tell the glory of your kingdom and speak of the mighty power, to make known to all people your mighty acts and the glorious splendour of your kingdom. Your kingdom is everlasting kingdom. Your domination endures throughout all ages. The Lord is sure in his words and faithful in all his deeds. The Lord upholds all those who fall and lifts up all those who bow down. Glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now and shall be forever. Amen. Christ, the Son of righteousness, rise in our hearts this day, enfolding us into the brightness of your love, and bear us at last to the heaven's horizon for your love's sake. Amen. And now time for our readings. Our first reading is from the book of Zechariah, Zechariah 9, verses 9 to 12. Rejoice greatly, O daughter Zion. Shout aloud, O daughter Jerusalem. Lo, that your king comes to you. Trumpet and victorious is he, humble and riding on a donkey, on a colt, the foal of a donkey. He will cut off the chariot from Ephraim and the war horse from Jerusalem. And the battle bow shall be cut off, and he shall command peace to the nations. His domination shall be from sea to sea, and from the river to the ends of the earth. As for you also, because of the blood of your covenant with you, I will set your prisoners free from the waterless pit. Return to the stronghold, O prisoners of hope. Today I declare that I will restore you double. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. And our second reading, our New Testament reading this morning, is from Romans 7, verses 15 to 25. I do not understand my own actions, for I do not know what I do and I want, but I do the very things I hate. Now if I do what I do not want, I agree with the law is good. But if in fact it I no longer do that, my sin will dwell within me. For I know that nothing good dwells within me, that is in my flesh. I can and will in that right, but I cannot be. For I do not do the good I want, but the evil I do not want is what I do. Now, if I do what I do not want, it is no longer that I do it, but sin that dwells within me. So I find it in the law, but when I must and want that is evil, that is good, evil lies close at hand. For I delight in the law of God in my inmost self, but I see in my members before law at war, and the law of my mind, it's making me captive to the law of sin and dwellers of my members. Wretched men who I am, who is to rescue me from the body of death? Thanks be to God, Jesus Christ our Lord. So then with my mind I am the slave of the law of God, but with my flesh I am the slave of the law of sin. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. And who knew on a Sunday morning I would be doing the biblical tongue twister that is the letter to the Romans. Not one I will be delving into in my sermon shortly. However, we come to our next hymn, and this is the moment where we should normally would say the children would leave out and go into their children's groups. However, I'm not too scary, and they can still listen if you have children, and if not, I'm sure they're all off doing fun things anyway. But now our next hymn is Meekness and Majesty. If I can press the button.
Meekness.
Excellent song there. One I'm glad that I didn't join in with, because I'm not quite sure I could have met that final note with my deep voice. We now come to our gospel reading. Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord. But to what I will compare this generation, it is like children sitting in the marketplace and calling to one another. We played the flute for you and you did not dance. We wailed and you did not mourn. For John came neither drinking nor eating. And they say, he has a demon. The Son of Man came eating and drinking. And they say, look, a glutton and a drunkard, a friend of tax collectors and sinners. Yet wisdom is vindicated by her deeds. Then he began to reproach the cities in which most of these deeds and power had been done, because they did not repent. Woe to you, Chorazin. Woe to you, Bethsaida, for it is a deed of power done to you and done to Tyre and Sidon, and repent long in sackcloth and ashes. But I tell you, on the day of judgment, it will be more tolerable for Tyre and Sidon than to you, and to you, Capernaum, will be exalted in heaven. No, you will now be brought down to Hades, for it is the deeds of power done in you that is done in Sodom, that is remain until this day. But I tell you that on the day of judgment it will be more tolerable for the land of Sodom than for you. And Jesus thanks his Father. At this time Jesus said, I thank you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, because you have hidden these things from the wise and the intelligent and revealed them to infants. Yes, Father, for such a glorious will, all things have been handed over to me by my Father. And no one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone whom the Son chooses to reveal him. Come to me, all you who are weary and carry heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your soul. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Lord, we have heard your word. We have read your scripture. May your word come through me. May our ears hear your words. May your words touch our hearts and minds. Inspire us to be your will on earth. Amen. One of the key things when you're sat in your seat in church as a reader or as a minister is you look and see these poor people who spent days practicing, who've got long passages to read, and then you think, I'm only going to preach on one of those verses. How mean is that? Especially when they are littered with some fantastic names in the Old Testament and of the old Eastern times. The key thing with those names is just to say them with a little bit of confidence and people won't know you're just hashing them together. But it's still a kind of feeling you have of, I'm really not going to talk very long about any of all that. I'm just going to talk about that little bit, because it's that little bit that just jumps out of the page. And for me, Thankfully, I did all the reading this morning, so I don't have to have that feeling. Because what I'm leading up to is, all I'm going to talk about is that reading from the Gospel of Matthew, around about verse 28 to 30. Come to me, all you are weary and carry heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your soul, for my yoke is easy and my burden is light. This is a very well-known phrase. It's one that if you were to go onto the internet, Google it and say, biblical scripture for when you're having trouble, what would it give you? This would be up there in the top five, at least top three of my mind. It's one of those things. We all have these heavy burdens we carry. You may not all have them at this moment, this day. You may be struggling. It hits you on different days. When I think of the burdens that we carry in life, I think of sometimes of the Greek god Atlas, who had they believed had the world on his shoulders. That big, huge, muscly man, I wish that was me, with a big globe on his shoulders. Sometimes it can feel so unbearing, we don't know how we carry it. You may have joined me on a 4 o'clock service, or any of us on our 4 o'clock, and one of the things I like to do is I take that busy day and wrap it up and throw it away. And this message for me is one of the important ones, because Jesus is calling to us. He is saying to us, momentary music playing in the background. He is saying to us, come to me and I will take away that heavy burden. But is he really? Is that really what it says here? It can be an easy thing to look at and say, this says, come to Jesus. And Jesus says, life's going to be so easy and it's going to be free of hassle and it's going to be so great. You just have to follow me and life is going to be perfect. And one of the key things of an early Christian is when we fall into that trap is we get to a point in life where it isn't easy and go, but he's not keeping his promises. And that's because this passage is sometimes misread. This passage is sometimes misinterpreted, in my view. Because what we're going to look at is about what Jesus is offering. He is calling everybody who is weary and who has a heavy burden, and he is offering them rest. He is there to take that burden, that is not doubt. He is taking away our sins and our worries and our concerns. The problem there is, we do as natural human beings tend to decide what we're going to give him. It's like maybe I'm out with my wife shopping, and I say, oh, give me some of those bags, dear. I'll carry some. My wife will look and go, well, I'll give you that heavy one and that one. But this is my really important clothes shopping that you're not going to crumple because I've just been in wherever. And I'm keeping this safe. I don't trust that you're not going to drop this in a puddle. I don't trust that you're not going to open it and see that I didn't buy one top, I bought three. It's that kind of thing. We're not going to give it over. And that's one of the things. He's not saying, come to me and give me the odds and sods. He's saying, come and give me everything. So we never feel truly rested. But then he's offering, take my yoke upon you. Now, that's the thing. When we think of a yoke, it's that big thing that if you're not right, it's a wooden thing that goes over your shoulders. The wood comes out, and if you think of it as a milkmaid, and they have big pails of milk on each end, a big yoke, and you carry it for carrying heavy items. Take his yoke and learn from him. Now, Jesus' yoke, if we look at his life and his journey in his testament, was never really an easy one. It wasn't a simple, easy life. It had a lot of challenges on there. It was tough. So maybe sometimes we should think, well, we're taking this yoke up, but it's going to be tough. But he's offering to learn from him, to see what he does, to be gentle and humble in heart, and to find the rest in our souls. And when I reflected on this, I thought about the different days and different week of this week that I've had. There has been days when I've looked at my watch and one moment it was 9 o'clock, the next minute it was 6. Those days have gone really quickly. Those have been enjoyable days. I've come away from my work and I've gone, whoa, that was a good day today and I've done loads and I've done this. And then I've thought of days when I've looked at my watch and it's 9 o'clock. It feels like the hours of ticking by, tick-tock, tick-tock. I've looked at my watch again and it's 9:04. Or I look at my watch and several hours have passed and I feel like nothing has been done. What have I done? I've got so much to do. It's that part of our lives where maybe we're doing something we don't enjoy, that is not food for our soul. It goes back to that really tongue-twistery reading from Romans about doing what you want to do and doing what you should do or could do or must do. The sins of the flesh, the sins of God, the tasks of God. It's important to understand what it is we do. If we are gentle and humble of heart, if we learn from the life of Jesus and carry that yoke with us, then we're going to have it easy. And it's a light burden, because that is an amazing thing to do. If we weigh ourselves down with worry, things we cannot change, things we cannot do, if we get deep into troublesome things, if we get ourselves into arguments, disagreements, if we are a pain to someone else, if we cause somebody else pain, these are not good things for our soul. We come away angry, we come away tense. It is a time when we need to take our moments away. Modern world, so you've heard me talk about it, mindfulness. My mindfulness moments can deem from me, I'll go sit in my back garden, if it's not raining, near my water feature, which is trickling water, close my eyes and just breathe and listen. The trickling of water, the tweeting of birds, the amazing creation around me, taking a moment in time. It could be I've started doing little crystal art things, which is very much of taking a thing and clicking on and making a beautiful picture. It's something to do to take my mind off the rigours of life, the busyness and the craziness. It is important that we step away from that. We take the yoke of Jesus and we go out. We live with a gentle and humble heart. But we learn from him. We've been learning from him for 2,000 years. And sometimes I look at our daily news and I wonder what humankind has actually learned. We choose to take those things that we want to learn and ignores those that we don't. It's why every Sunday or every morning we come in confession, because we know we have made those errors. But Jesus is there for us. He knows the Father and the Father knows the Son. And he chose to share that with us. And there's that passage in verse 27 where it says, all things have been handed over to me from my Father. No one knows the Son except the Father. And no one knows the Father except the Son. And the important bit, and anyone to whom the Son chooses to reveal himself. So Jesus revealed himself to us through the disciples, through the scriptures. So in doing that, he revealed God himself. He offered to take away our heavy burdens. So as we go forward in the week, let's not just go, right, I'm going to give you that burden, this one's really important. I've got to look after this one myself, because do you know, God, I've got to keep an eye on it because I'm a bit of a control freak. That's me. I do that. I do that with my daily tasks at work. I'll delegate out, but the really, really important one, I'm not giving to anybody else, because if they completely mess that up, oh, it's going to cause me so much pain. No, we're going to give that to God and let him look after and deal with it. But it's not going to be an easy life. It's not going to be an easy journey, because Jesus' yoke is not a yoke that has nothing on it. It is a yoke that says, go out, share this message. Be challenged. Have a humble heart and be gentle. And as we know in this world, when you are like that, you get sometimes the rough end of the stick. But no, he's there with you, holding you up. For he is his yoke is easy and his burden is light, because he's going to carry everything that you can't carry. Amen. We now come to declare our faith in the words of the Creed. I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who is conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the commission of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. We now come to our time of prayer. I have a list of intercessions. I have one on our Darsby site. Feel free to write in the Facebook chat if you have any. I will momentary glance and squint at them there. If you don't want to bring them forward into the public domain, there will be plenty of opportunities of silence to bring them to your to prayer in your heart. You can say them out loud. I don't think anyone can hear you, because this is only one way. So let us come together in prayer. Let us sit or kneel, hands together, eyes closed. God, we come before you. We bring our burdens to you and lay them to you, with the hope and knowledge that we are worthy to pick up your yoke, to go forth to deliver your message of hope, salvation, grace and mercy. Lord, we know when we come to follow you, the life you offer is not a life of ease, not a perfect life. But we accept the challenges, knowing that you are with us, that through you, you offer the knowledge and relationship with God. We know that when we pray, you hear our words, you hear our hearts and minds, our hopes and our dreams, our fears and our worries. Lord, we pray for the Anglican Church in Sri Lanka. We pray for the mission of the seafarers. We pray as churches begin to open their doors for moments of prayer, for services once more, that we not forget the blessing that the technology has given us. Did we allow those to come back to those buildings in their time when they are ready? Do we not let fear, that we not get rush in foolishly, that all things are done safely, and that we work together as a family, as a church of people, to share your word, to celebrate, to thank and to worship you. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord, we pray for the local asylum seekers, those housed in and around the Darsby area, for those awaiting decision, awaiting placement. We cannot understand or comprehend leaving everything we own to go to a place that is foreign to us, with languages we may not know, challenges we cannot think. We pray for all the work of all volunteers, all helpers, and all professionals as they look to bring hope and love and joy and caring to those people. We pray for the Runcorn and District Food Banks and all the food banks in the surrounding areas in these difficult times. More have turned to food banks, more have taken to desperation. Let them hold their heads high. Let us support them as we would hope to be supported. We pray for all the schools, for Darsbury, Moore, Sandymore, and any local schools to ourselves, as your young children go back, may they be filled with knowledge and wisdom. May they learn from your ways, not from the error and anger and hatred of the world. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord, we pray for those who are sick, be that at home or in hospital, be it physical or mental. We pray for all those hard-working carers, the NHS. As the NHS celebrates its 75th birthday, we think of all those doctors, nurses, caring for all those. We pray especially for Karen Bateson, Simon Hall, Shirley Cam, Nan, Molly, and Stephen McIntyre. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord, we pray for the community around us in these times of pandemic. As easing and lockdown measures are eased, let us not rush in like fools. Let us be sensible. Let us not let this virus take back again those who have been impacted, those who have lost their lives and lost their loved ones. Those who have given ours, let us not undo the good we have done. But let us flourish. Let us not fall to fear, to anger, to hate. But continue in community, in unity, as we are together. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And Lord, we pray for those no longer with us. It is not an end, but the beginning of something new. For the Father knows the Son, and the Son knows the Father, and for whom he shares that with, he offers the gift of eternal life to those who but simply believe. So we bring before you Brian Booth, Elsie Taylor, Beryl Smith, Margaret Leather, and Peter Smith. We bring to you their families. Let their hearts be filled with joy and joyous memories of those moments, those happy times, those times together. Let them know that they will always remain in their heart, with them forever. Wipe away their tears, for it is not a time of sadness, but a time of joy, that they may know and one day be reconciled with their loved one. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. So, Lord, let us go out in this wondrous world of creation, a a world you created for us. And when we are troubled, let us share those things with you. Not the little things, not the things we think you can hold, but let us bring all things to you as you shoulder our burden with us. And let us take your yoke so that we may be more like you, that we may be gentle, humble, caring, merciful. We accept there will be challenge, but it will not beat us. We accept there will be hardness, but we will not be alone. You give us our strength. You give us our salvation, so that when we are in despair, we can see your shining hope. We bring these prayers to you, our God and Father. Amen. And we pray together the words of the Lord's Prayer as our Saviour taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. And now we come to our final hymn. Yes, that time has gone so quickly. It must be because we had a really lovely and enjoyable service. Well, I hope we have anyway. Our final hymn this morning is All Creatures of God Our King. What a great song to have the final one. As everybody knows, my hidden charismatic within me loving to shout hallelujahs in there when I can. Won't it be good when we're all back in church together and I can make sure you're all shouting out those hallelujahs? I'm sure you do. So let us come together. The Lord bless you and watch over us, and the Lord make his face upon us and be gracious to us. The Lord looks kindly on us and give us peace. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among us and remain with us always. Amen. May the risen Christ grant us the joy of eternal life. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. Thank you, everybody, this morning. Oh, thank you for joining me. I am back tomorrow, but more importantly, I haven't forgot this week, David. I am back at 4 o'clock. So if you wish to join me for a shorter, quieter, evensong, relaxing bit of prayer, I will be here. It has been amazing to have you all on. It's been amazing to share and worship you this morning. I hope you're filled with rejoicing. I hope you're thankful, and I hope you have enjoyed your worship. It would be great when we're all back together, but it is also great that we can come together like this. If you have any prayer requests, just throw them on the Facebook page. I will include them in the 4 o'clock if I've not done already, and that you'll bring these after time. If you're watching this and it's maybe 2 o'clock because you had a lie-in because you've been working 6 days a week and you've been doing 12-hour shifts, maybe that heavy burden be released by rest and sleep. Again, you'll find it on the webpage. I will cover any extra prayer requests at 4 o'clock or tomorrow, even when you'll have me then. God bless you. Take care. Have an amazing day. May the sun shine on you and may your sun shine in your heart. God bless and see you soon.